You're relaxing on the couch, everything is quiet, and then it happens. Your perfectly calm cat suddenly leaps up, eyes wide, and starts battling an invisible enemy in the corner of the room. The internet has a name for these mysterious foes. Greebles. Tiny, invisible gremlins that only our cats can see. It's a funny idea, right? But what if I told you the truth is even more incredible than invisible monsters? Your cat isn't crazy, and they aren't seeing ghosts. They're experiencing a reality that you and I are completely blind to. In this video, we're going to decode the mystery of greebles. We'll explore the hidden world your cat sees every single day, and I'll give you three simple ways to join them in their world and make your bond stronger than ever. So what's really going on? The short answer is that your cat is a sensory superhero. Their brain is processing a massive amount of information that our human senses simply can't detect. First, let's talk about their hearing. You might think that your house is silent, but to your cat, it's a symphony of sound. Humans can hear frequencies up to about 20,000 Hz. Cats, they can hear up to 64,000 Hz, and some studies suggest even higher. This means they can hear the high frequency squeak of a mouse inside the walls, the ultrasonic buzz of a fluorescent light bulb that we can't perceive, or even the tiny scuttling of a spider across the floorboards. What looks like them staring at a wall is actually them tracking a sound source with laser-like focus. But it goes beyond sound. Look at their whiskers. They're not just cute facial hair. The scientific name is vibrissae, and they are exquisitely sensitive tactile instruments. Your cat can literally feel the air move. A tiny draft from under a door, the subtle air pressure change of a spider crawling down its web, their whiskers detect it, creating a 3D map of their immediate surroundings without even needing to see. What looks like a stare at nothing could be them processing a change in airflow. And then there are their eyes, which are truly incredible. Cats can see ultraviolet or UV light, a spectrum of light that's completely invisible to us. This means that sunlight hitting the wall might reveal patterns, or they might see the faint trails left by certain insects that reflect UV light. They also have a higher concentration of rod cells in their eyes, making them masters at detecting even the slightest movement in low light. That tiny dust mite dancing in a sunbeam you can barely see, to your cat, it's a full-blown target. You've seen that otherworldly glow when light catches them in the dark, right? That's caused by something called the tapetum lucidum. It's a mirror-like layer behind their retina that bounces light back through it, essentially giving their eyes a second chance to absorb every single photon. It's biological night vision. And they perceive its movement with stunning clarity. This is thanks to their high flicker fusion rate. Think of it like a camera's frame rate. We see a movie as smooth as motion, but an old, choppy film looks flickery. A cat's brain processes images much faster than ours, so a movement that's a blur to us, like the flutter of an insect's wings, is a crisp, clear, and irresistible series of individual frames to them. Okay, so they have a suite of sensory superpowers, but why does it trigger such a dramatic, pouncy reaction? This is the why, and it connects everything back to their core identity. Every domestic cat is a predator, hardwired with the instincts of their wild ancestors. And these instincts are most powerful during specific times of the day. Cats are crepuscular. That's a fancy word meaning they are most active at dawn and dusk, the prime hunting time for their natural prey. So when you're winding down for the evening, your cat's brain is just clocking in for its hunting shift. Their senses are heightened, and they are primed to react to the slightest stimulus. That dust mite caught by their tapetum lucidum, that air current felt by their whiskers, it all screams prey to their brain. The greebel attack is them acting on millions of years of evolutionary programming. They are practicing staying sharp, being a cat. Understanding this changes everything. Your cat isn't being random, they are being a cat. They are performing the essential job their ancestors have for millions of years. Seeing this behavior isn't a sign of weirdness, it's a sign of a healthy, instinctual cat. And that's a beautiful thing. But what happens when the source of that excitement is something they can see or hear but can't possibly reach? This is where greebles can sometimes be a sign of something else entirely. Redirected excitement. Imagine your cat is sitting at the window and sees another cat or a squirrel in the yard. Their entire being ignites with the instinct to chase, to defend their territory. But they're trapped behind glass. All that intense, frustrated energy has to go somewhere. So they might spin around and launch an attack on the nearest thing, the carpet, a pillow, or what appears to be thin air. It's an emotional pressure release valve. So how can we, as their human companions, help our little super predators thrive? It's all about giving those instincts a positive outlet. Here are three simple things you can start doing today. Number one is to complete the hunt. Become the leader of a satisfying hunt. Engage them with a one toy, making it skitter and hide, which satisfies their high flicker fusion rate and their tracking skills. At the end of a 10 to 15 minute play session, make sure you let them catch the prey. This completes the natural hunt, catch, kill sequence, which is incredibly rewarding and prevents frustration that can lead to redirected behaviors. Number two is to enrich the environment. Prevent boredom-induced greebles. If your cat is frustrated by things they see outside, give them more interesting things to do inside. Food puzzles, cat trees in their windows with bird feeders outside, or even just a simple cardboard box can provide the mental and physical stimulation they need to feel fulfilled. And number three, know when it's not greebles. While this behavior is normal 99% of the time, very rarely it can be a sign of something else. In older cats, excessive staring can be a symptom of cognitive dysfunction. In very rare cases, extreme twitching and frantic chasing could be related to a neurological condition called feline hyperthesesia syndrome. If this behavior seems obsessive, it's accompanied by distress, or if your cat is hurting themselves, it's always best to have a quick chat with your vet just to be safe. So, the next time you see your cat launch a full-scale assault on an empty corner, you'll know the incredible truth. You're seeing a magnificent creature that feels the room breathe through its whiskers, sees the world in night vision, and perceives motion with a clarity we can only dream of. You're witnessing their ancient wild instincts playing out right in your living room. Understanding this is the key to a deeper bond, because when you see their world, you understand their needs. If you love decoding this mystery and want to learn more secrets of the feline mind, make sure you subscribe to Cat Cognition. I post new videos every week to help you and your cat live the best lives together.